Excellencies, distinguished colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. It's a real pleasure for me and a great honor for me to be here with you today at this opening ceremony of the World Telecommunication and ICT Indicators Symposium 2014. On behalf of Dr. Amran Tuwe, Secretary General of ITU and other elected officials, we are very grateful to the government of Georgia for hosting this symposium and for the tremendous hospitality you have provided, including yesterday's excursion to the UNESCO heritage site of Mosque Hatta, one of the oldest continually inhabited cities in the world, and also the wonderful evening, the dinner, gala dinner we enjoyed. I know that you made a lot of effort to make this World Telecommunication Indicators Symposium very special. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, we have been following ICT trends for many years. I'm pleased to see that many countries have been making great strides towards the information and knowledge society. I want to congratulate you and hope that when we unveil this year's ICT Development Index at lunchtime, this will also be evident. But since our Prime Minister will travel to foreign countries immediately after this opening ceremony, I'd like to just highlight that the secret up to now, that according to our latest statistics to be published at lunchtime, Georgia is one of very few countries last year made enormous progress in the ranking. Because today, the ICT development everywhere seems to be mature. It's very hard to move one rank ahead. But Georgia had made several ranks ahead. How many? We leave this to secret to be announced by the director of PDT. So congratulations. Having said that, let me stop and pose two questions. Do we really know the population that remains unconnected despite statistics showing that there are 7 billion mobile cellular subscriptions? Do we know who are the unconnected despite that 3 billion people have access to the internet, or that 2.3 billion people have access to mobile broadband? I want to call upon the member states to help us identify the really unconnected people so we may know who to target as we continue to invest in infrastructure. It is also very important for governments as they formulate a public policy aimed at stimulating investment and competition in this sector. Distinguished colleagues, since 1889 to date, when we are about to commemorate ITU's 150th anniversary, ITU has been collecting and processing telecommunication statistics and indicators thanks to the support and the contribution by the countries. Our work in ICT measurement has grown from strength to strength. Today, ITU maintains ICT statistics for 200 economies and over 100 indicators. I have no doubt that this cooperation with countries will continue in the future. I can give you my word. ITU is committed to ensure that very high standard is maintained as we help countries monitor their progress towards attaining universal access, which in turn could drive economies, education, health, and everything that we do. At this moment, let me congratulate Mr. Ibrahim Asanu, the newly re-elected director of the Telecommunication Development Bureau of ITU, and his team for successfully re-engineering what used to be a very small technical meeting to the big symposium that it has become today. I see the ministers, director generals of both national statistical offices and telecommunication regulatory authorities. And I also see many experts and very senior government officials in the room. Of course, Georgia is a very attractive tourist destination. That is one of the reasons we see many participants here. I heard from our Prime Minister last year, Georgia attracted more than 5 million tourists. Not everybody has chance to visit Georgia, but anyhow, we see many delegates come to join us. This diversity is crucial as we need political will and expertise to drive the important process of data collection, processing, and reporting. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, as the ITU Secretary General-elect, I want to assure you here and now that I continue to provide unflinching support for the work related to measuring the information society. This is all the more important as the international community has now set the sustainable development goals that recognize that the ICTs play a pivotal role for future attainment. Thank you for your attention and look forward to engaging with you personally and to listen to the many interesting sessions over the next 2 days. Thank you very much.